Hello YouTube. A number of subscribers have asked if I would do a video on my cube collection. Here goes. So I sort of resisted doing this video for a while because I didn't really think it's that interesting to look at someone else's cube collection. Cubes are kind of all the same, and I think we all have collected kind of the same ones. In the beginning, of course, I thought getting a better cube would make me better. That's true to a certain extent if you have like a Rubik's branded cube, but at some point, of course, it's practice that makes you better. That didn't stop me from accumulating a bunch of cubes in the beginning before landing on Zanchis as my favorite and my mains. Of course, I tried different formats, you know, 2x2s, 4x4s, different, you know, Mega Minx, different kinds of cubes. This, of course, is a Void that has my custom stickers I had made for it. But to understand my cube collection, I really need to take you on a tour of my house because I have my cubes scattered throughout to make it convenient for me, sort of wherever I am, to grab a cube and sort of have fun. So the first stop on my tour would be our downstairs coat closet, which has, well, it has the liquor high enough that the kids can't get to it, and it has my cubes that I use downstairs. This is a Shang Xiao 2x2. With my gray on top, black on bottom, Fulbright color scheme that you've seen on my 3x3s. Here is my Zanchi 3x3. Actually, I take it back. This is my Weilong 3x3 with the same scheme and my custom G stickers. This is a Maru CX3. Of course, the cubic Cubics design. It's a great cube. I use it at this point for a lot of my practice and F2L. An OLL learning. Right now you can see that it's got some Sharpie on it. I'm trying to learn or better understand partial edge control, and that these symbols are helping me. Here's a Moyu Aosu, I'm not really sure how to pronounce it, in primary, which is the white plastic, but not totally white. It's the sort of semi-transparent grayish plastic. I haven't restickered it yet to my scheme, but I plan on it. And here is a Diane Mega Minx without the ridges. I don't really solve Mega Minx very much. My preferred one has ridges, but that one's in my office at work. So those are my cubes that are downstairs. These are the ones that I grab the most when I make videos, so you've seen them in a lot of my videos. And the next stop on the tour is my kids' bathroom, where I keep a Zanchi in the drawer. This is where I spend a lot of time cubing on the floor here while they take a bath. This Zanchi is maybe the first or second one I got. It's a little dark in here, sorry. The thing that's unique about this one is it has these matte finish stickers from, I think it's Cube Depot. And I really liked these for a while. I like the finish. I like that they're not shiny and thick. But I don't ever really like the shades, and they're not fitted, they're just square. They're chipping and peeling a little. I've had this cube for quite a while, but this is probably my most worked-in cube and one of my favorites, as Zanchi. And the next stop on the tour is at my desk at home, where I have, just like downstairs, one of each of the cube formats that I tend to solve, although I don't solve Mega Minx that much. This is a 2x2 Shang Xiao, a very good cube. Standard sticker scheme with brights. This is another Zanchi. I've got Zanchis everywhere. This one, like the one in the bathroom, has these matte finish Cube Depot stickers, which just helps me realize this is one of my first speed cubes. This is probably second or third one I owned. Very good cube. This one in particular I like. It's clicky but smooth. Some of my Zanchis are really smooth. This one still has that little clickiness, which I like. Excellent cube. This is a 4x4 Moyu Weisu. I haven't restickered it yet. Once I got the Aosu, however you pronounce it, Aosu, and realized how much better that is, I didn't really use this anymore. This is a very good cube, though. Certainly better than the Shang Xiaos that I used to use. I just don't solve 4x4 that much anymore, or at least haven't recently. I want to get back into 4x4, and that Aosu, whatever it is, downstairs, will probably be the cube I start using a lot for that. And then this is a stickerless Diane Megaminx with ridges. Again, I don't sell Megaminx that much, but I do find it fun once in a while. The last layer is kind of confusing for me, and I'm not that good at it. But I really like the stickerless one, and I like the ridges. And the last stop, well, I guess the last part of the stop in my room, is to the mother load, which is to a whole bunch of cubes that I store in a drawer over here. Also on my desk right now are a few cubes that I just got from the cubicle that I haven't restickered or even set up yet. They're still dry. They're not lubed yet. But this is a Maru CX3, like the black one downstairs. Since that one I sort of dedicated to practice with the top layer, unstickered or whatever, I wanted to get another one. I'm going to set this up with gray, like my standard stickers scheme. I like this cube a lot. It tends to lock up on me a little. Although there it was pretty smooth. It's a really good cube if you get it tensioned right. So that's the CX3, not set up yet. Here's an Owlong. Jury's still out for me on whether I like the Owlong. I know I did that unboxing. It grows on me by the day. The only thing is my fingers tend to get stuck in between the cubies sometimes. The lighting here is really bad. I'm sorry. I don't have my light set up. But, you know, if you get them set up right, I think, I really do think the Owlong can become a good cube. This just isn't there yet for me. And here's a black one. Same thing. This one I did set up a little, and it's starting to perform a lot better. Yeah, it's definitely starting to perform better. I still do get my fingers stuck in those cubies, though. It does lock up on me a little. But anyway, good cube growing on me. We'll see. And so those are the cubes that are out on my desk. In a drawer here, I've stored sort of the mother load, a bunch of cubes that I don't use that much anymore or that I just sort of bought as collector's items. And let's see what those look like. And I'll just start going through it bit by bit. Here is a Diane 2x2. I never really got into the Diane 2x2. It's smoother than the Shang Xiao's, which I actually don't like. I get corner twists, and the corners tend to pop out on me. So I don't do 2x2 that much, but this one just never really grew on me. This one is sort of a nostalgia cube for me. It's my first Rubik's Cube. It's literally a Rubik's Cube. It's the first cube I owned, at least the first cube I owned since, you know, I was a little kid. I bought this at Walgreens, and bought it for my kid to keep him busy at a wedding, and it, of course, is the cube that wound up getting me into cubing. It's, you know, like most Rubik's, it's not that great, doesn't corner cut or whatever, but I did use it enough and wound up lubing it a little, and, you know, it's actually not terrible. I mean, it's not great, but it's not terrible. So anyway, that's Rubik's. Here I have a new Rubik's. I don't know why, just maybe for reference or something, but brand new, never really been used Rubik's. Here is a 30th anniversary, I believe that's what it is, yeah, 30th anniversary Rubik's cube. It's made out of wood, which is a little unique. The bottom has no stickers. The other faces have translucent stickers. It's novel, and I like that it's wood. It unfortunately doesn't perform well at all. I'd say it actually performs worse than a standard Rubik's Cube. But it was unique, and I liked it just because it was sort of a collector's item. Here's a couple Owlongs. I'm not going to take them both out of the box. The only thing is, one of these is transparent, and I showed this on an unboxing video. I thought it was neat that it was transparent. The colors are very, very hard to distinguish from each other, but sort of a fun cube. performs pretty well, which is pretty neat for a transparent cube. Just very hard to distinguish the colors from each other. The other Yulong is just a black one. Here's a spring set from Amaru. Here is a... I believe this is a Guhong V2. Yeah, a Guhong V2. One of the earlier cubes I bought when I was just experimenting, didn't know the difference between cubes. At work, I actually use a Guhong V2, not a Zanshi. They're actually really good, but one of the first cubes I had, I don't use it any longer. Let's see what this one is. Oh yeah, this is a Cube for You tiled cube. I really wanted to see what a sort of stickerless cube was that wasn't just dyed plastic like the Dianes, and so this is that. It popped. We're back. This is a cube that I actually really like. It doesn't corner cut all that well, but it has a nice crispy feel, and I like that it's tiled and not stickered. I don't really use it that much, but it was sort of a neat early cube I bought. This is a stickerless Shangxiao. When I was solving 2x2 more, I liked having a stickerless one. I actually think stickerless cubes solve better than stickered ones, even though I don't have many of them. This is a Lego cube, if I can get it out of the box. This is a Lego cube that I actually made out of a mini cube and glued on the tiles. It's bandageable. The plates are exactly far enough apart that they can be bandaged. I don't solve bandaged cubes. I actually made this just because I thought it was fun and my kids love Lego. The performance is not terrible, but again, I don't really speed solve with this. It's just sort of neat to have. Here's another cube for you. This one has transparent plastic and shiny tiles, but otherwise it's sort of the same cube. It's a little looser than the other one. Performs, not terribly. Although I just screwed up that OLL, but it doesn't perform terribly. But again, I don't use it very much. Here is a Shangxiao 4x4 V4, I believe, in my standard color scheme. This was one of the cubes that I modded. I did a Consta and Florian mod. I might have over-modded it a little, and I can't get the tensions right on this one. But it's a good cube. I thought these were great cubes modded until I got the Wei Su and then Ao Su. Here is a better modding job I did on a similar cube. I don't know how well you can tell there, but I actually think this one came out really great. This one performs actually pretty well. I just don't know how to do 4x4 really well. But this was a good cube, Shangxiao 4x4. I did a really good job modding this, I think. But again, I don't use it because now I have the Mouyus. Here is a Maru CX3. I believe this one's transparent. Yep. It has transparent stickers on a clear cube, unlike the Yulong, which is actually dyed plastic. This performs very well. Like a CX3. I don't use it very much, but it's kind of neat. I like transparent cubes. Here is a Zanshi. Nothing particularly special about it, except that I set it up with gray on top. This was when I was experimenting with new color schemes. And I tried gray on top of a black cube. I don't really love it. I think that it's actually very hard to see the gray on the black. Not much to say about this cube, except that it's a Zanshi, and I stickered it differently and then never really did much with it. Here is a Scube. I frankly don't even remember the company. I don't know how to solve a Scube. I can solve it if I watch a tutorial and then I forget. That's a cube. Here is a Lubix Zanshi that I have in my color scheme. This is, for me, a really weird cube. On the one hand, it's exceptionally smooth, as you'd expect from a Lubix Zanshi. The tensions are a little tight, so maybe I just need to loosen it, but it doesn't have any clickiness at all. And I sort of like having clickiness in a cube. Messed up that OLL again. That's sort of why I like Zanshis, is they're smooth but clicky. This Lubix one, it's a nice mod, but it's just so perfectly smooth that I don't really love it. Here is a CamCuber 57mm Zanshi. For a while, when I was getting really into setups, I thought that getting a really well set up Zanshi would, again, make all the difference. Like a lot of people have said about the CamCuber Zanshis, I actually just find it kind of sticky. It gets better as you warm it up, and at that point it actually performs pretty well. But, you know, at this point, not a cube I really use. It's, I guess, a bit of a collector's item. I don't know, they're numbered, so maybe there's something unique about that, but I really support Cameron and what he's been doing. I know that it's sort of the first of the really well-made custom lubed cubes, and so I think that's pretty cool. I got a 55mm one also at one point when I was doing 55mm also from him. Here is a floppy cube. I don't even know, YJ, I guess. Just sort of novel. I don't really solve that. Let's see. Here is a Shangxiao Aurora, I think it's called. I don't really remember. I actually really, really dislike this cube. And I really dislike this cube. So, it's smooth, it's really smooth, it has those channels, and it cuts a little. I mean, it cuts a lot, but it just locks up on me when I solve. I've never really dug it. Let's see, we're getting towards the end. Here is a Panshi. I had such high hopes for Panshi. I got a DIY one, I couldn't set it up right. I don't know, maybe I can give it another chance, but it just never really performed anywhere near the way I expected a Panshi to. I thought it was going to be a really improved Zanshi, and it's not. I just don't really like it. I think that's kind of universal among people, that it was disappointing. Not better than a Zanshi. So there's that. Hang on, I gotta deal with my dog. Here is a crystal cube, the one I hacked. Let's see if I can remember which cube I take out. I think it's the yellow blue one. Yep, and if I do, and then I use a paper clip, I can get it to light up. There we go. I have a video on my channel about making this and solving with it, and it's a neat cube because you could do that. But it took a lot of work to make it, and I think this is, besides the one I gave away in my contest, this is the only one like this that exists. So, neat cube. You can solve in the dark. I, of course, really don't do that. Here is probably the coolest cube. Sorry, I had to deal with my dog there. This is a transparent Zanshi. There's rumors that this is a super unique cube, only 100 made, something like that. The clear was a prototype. I don't know if any of that's true. I don't know if it's that rare. But I bought this off somebody a while back, and I just applied translucent stickers that I bought from Lighttake. I think it's a pretty neat cube. It performs just like a Zanchi. I never use it. I feel like I shouldn't use it, especially if it's maybe that rare. But it's really cool to have, and being such a fan of Zanchis, I really like having a transparent one. Then in the back here, I've got a few cubes that I never use. Here's a Type C Whitlong. I bought it, I unstickered it, planned on restickering it with my Scheme, and just never really liked the cube. I don't know, just something about it never really felt that great to me, but I wanted to experiment with a Whitlong. Let's see, a few mini cubes in the back here. And then a square one, a Calvin square one. I don't know square one. I could, saw the top and bottom and get it basically into being square, but that's really all I know. So that's it, a few mini cubes, one of the really mini Zanchis, and then some novelty cheap mini cubes that I think came for free with some other things. And what is this, like a 50 millimeter Zanchi? Kind of good for travel or for throwing in a little bag, but not something that I really use very much. So, like I said, that was sort of the mother load. Bunch of cubes that I collected. I don't really touch these. I'm glad to have them. I use the ones downstairs and at my desk the most. And on to the last stop. And actually, a quick detour. I'd forgotten about some cubes in my kids' rooms. Let's start with this one. It's a SpongeBob toy from a Burger King Happy Meal, or whatever they call them at Burger King. This doesn't operate like a standard cube in terms of turning, but it's still a puzzle. And you basically slide these pieces up and down. There's an open slot. It's kind of like a 3D 16 puzzle. Kind of a fun one. The kids love it. I bought it on eBay. The Homer Simpson 2x2. Fun one. It's, it doesn't turn very well, obviously. It's a Rubik's Ram. But it's fun, and you could do funny things with it. The kids love it. I almost never solve it, but it's fun to have. A Mickey Mouse 2x2, same thing. This is not official. It's not licensed by Rubik's or Disney, so definitely some form of copyright and perhaps trademark violation there. But the kids like that one, too. You could do Ninja Mickey, which they find hilarious. Let's see, a official Rubik's Cube from Disneyland. We go to Disneyland quite a bit. We don't live too far. And the kids love this one also. It's a super cube because the stickers can be misoriented in terms of direction. I don't know how to solve super cubes, so I get it solved, but you get Mickey turned on the center here. Sorry, I had to cut there because of my dog again. This is a cube that a friend brought back from the Louvre. It's an official Rubik's Cube. If I could find the logo, there it is. Each of the faces has a piece of art from the Louvre, obviously the Mona Lisa being one of the most famous. It's a super cube, so the direction matters. That makes this hard for me. Also, the colors are not that distinct on each face, so that also makes it a little hard. I only finished the Mona Lisa face. It turns like a Rubik's. That also makes it hard because it doesn't turn very well. Anyway, interesting cube and a nice souvenir from a trip. And then the last one is this Scrooble, I think it's called. I got this as a stocking stuffer over the holidays. I solved it for about 5 minutes, solved, played with it, whatever you want to call it, before it came apart and the whole thing popped apart. And putting it back together was a beast. It's like a Shang Xiao inside, all the same kind of shaped pieces, just one that's not made very well. And it took me literally 3, 4, 5 hours of sitting in front of the TV and patiently sort of trying one thing, trying another, trying to get all the pieces to hold before I got it to get back together. At least it gave me an opportunity to lube it. It works a little bit better now. It's a fun puzzle. I mean, it's kind of like Boggle meets a 3D puzzle, so it's fun. I guess I have a distinct advantage over people I play with, although I'd still say it's very, very hard to use. It's a very hard game. So anyway, that's it. That was the detour. And the last stop of the tour at home is next to my bed, where I keep in the nightstand a Zanchi. This was actually my first speed cube. I bought this right after I bought a Rubik's Cube at Walgreens, and when I realized that a Rubik's Cube just wasn't very good. It has my color scheme, gray on top, Fulbrights, and black on the bottom with my G sticker. I love this cube. This is probably one of my favorites, and this is the one I usually travel with. That's it for the tour at home. Off to my office. And so over here, for the last stop on the tour, is my office at work, where I have on display behind me by my printer a bunch of cubes. Each one of these is black, and each has Fulbrights on it with yellows on top. So these are not stickered in my standard scheme on white cubes with gray on top. These are ones that I tend to solve while I'm on conference calls and sort of sitting around the office thinking. They tend to be quite a conversation piece having them on display behind me. So I'll get into each one of those, but before I do, I wanted to talk about two things I missed when I went through the other cubes earlier. The first was, and this was in that motherlode drawer in my office at work, this is a Zanchi. What's unique about this Zanchi, which looks like a black Zanchi, it has pink stickers, which when I used to order Fulbrights, for whatever reason, sets came with pink, and I never really liked those. Now they come with fluorescent red when you order Fulbrights. But this cube is not a standard Zanchi, not a standard black Zanchi at least. It started as a stickerless cube, and you can tell if I take a few cubies out, the torpedoes are still colored and the centers are still colored. I didn't modify those. I'll explain that in a second. And basically what happened was I really liked the stickerless cubes. I thought the plastic on them felt different than the plastic on the black cubes. And there's a whole bunch of controversy about this, and I don't really want to spend this video getting into it, but there's a whole bunch of controversy about whether the plastics are different. At work, I actually have access to an FTIR machine, which will do analysis of materials. And when I analyze them, there is actually a difference between the black plastic and the colored plastic in the stickerless Zanchis. It's not a major difference, and I'm not a materials expert, but it was a slight difference, which sort of reinforced what I had just felt in using them. So one of the things I did was I took this cube apart. I dyed it black by using RIT dye, and there's some instructions online on how to do this. Some people do this for 3D printed cubes that print in that sort of primary or white. In any event, I dyed this black, put it back together, stickered it. It looks for all intents and purposes like a Zanchi. Theoretically, this is a competition legal Zanchi that's made out of the stickerless plastic but looks black. I did this about a month or two before Crazy Bad Cuber did exactly the same thing. He and I came to totally different conclusions. His conclusion was that he couldn't tell the difference at all. My conclusion was I could tell a slight difference if I compared the dyed black Zanchi against the one that was originally black. This has my old stickers on it. This was before I did colored stickers. I actually, now that I look at this again, I actually kind of like that sticker. It's a little simpler than the ones I do. This cube's performance is pretty bad for no reason other than that I took it in the pool. I was trying to do underwater solves to make a video that didn't turn out that well. But in any event, this is a stickerless Zanchi that looks like a black Zanchi. Cool experiment, totally worked out fine. I'll link to that. But wanted to spend a few minutes on that one because I think that's kind of unique. And as I reach back here for a 2x2, I'm reminded that I made a mistake earlier in the video when I described the other 2x2s I had as Shangxiaos. I don't have Shangxiao 2x2s. I don't even know if they make 2x2s. These are Witt Eden Witt 2s, and I think all of mine are V2s. And so this is a black one. Nothing unique about it. Everybody knows the feel of a Witt 2. I'm not that fast on 2x2, but I just find it to be a fun cube. The 3x3 in my office is a Guhong V2. This is a fantastic cube. It's not as good in my eyes as a Zanchi generally, but this cube, this particular version, happens to be very good. Maybe it's just because I've used it a lot and worked it in, maybe because of the way I tensioned and lubed it, but this is a great cube and it serves me really well at work. The 4x4 I have is a Wei Su. Not as good as the Aosu, which I have at home, but I don't solve 4x4 that much, and to have it at work, this works really well. Really happy with this one, totally unmodded, just lubed, and actually I haven't restickered it yet. It has the standard Moyu shades. I want to resticker it so it matches all the other cubes here. The 5x5 I have is a Shang Xiao. I basically never solve 5x5. I got really into it for a little while. I'm very, very slow at it. Just never really got that exciting for me, but I have one and it makes me look like I know what I'm doing more by having one more cube out on display and people get intrigued by the big one. And then finally I have a Diane Ridged Mega Minx in black. The only thing that's unique about this one is that I spent a lot of time choosing the sticker shades. I think I went on Cubicle and ordered every single shade that they had available in Mega Minx and one at a time. Chose each sticker shade for contrast against the other stickers. And I think I came out with a really good scheme. I have a video on my site about the stickers I used for that. I don't solve Mega Minx a lot, like I mentioned, but this one is very good. When I solve it, this is the one I prefer to use. And except for the last layer, I'm okay at it. The last layer just throws me. So that was a very long video, certainly longer than I thought it would be on my cube collection. I hope you enjoyed it. And I will try and keep this up to date as I get new cubes. Thanks for watching.